Hey guys, today we're going to be working on the 5th generation 4RUNNER straight axle project. My friend Derek and my friend Justin came over to help me work on it. We're going to modify the upper plate where it mounts on the inner part of the frame rail. It needs to be cut 3/4 up from the back to the front. It needs 3/4 up, it needs to be cut and coped. The frame tapers a little bit, so it needs to be pinched to the frame. And then we need to fully weld up these cradles. So let's do it, guys. I know a lot of people have been really excited for us to get working on the 5th generation 4RUNNER straight-axle project. So let's do it.
Loud noises!
Alright guys, we got pretty far this evening on this. We just ran out of time. It's like 11 o'clock at night. Derek and I got this modified here. This piece was on here so we could use it to push against. We could have this shape, you see. It's kind of the shape of the frame rail. So we'll coat this piece here where it needs to be so that can fit into here as soon as we're back to work on it. Tomorrow, Derek's gonna come back over. So we'll continue working on the 5th gen 4RUNNER with him, and we'll get that piece all made out, and then we'll move on to the passenger side. So we'll catch you guys tomorrow. Back working on the 4RUNNER, guys. Derek and I are gonna go ahead and take the cradle piece here that we put together yesterday, and we're gonna get it fully welded.
well, as welded as much as we can, because once we put this in the frame, we're not going to be able to get to these spots. We're not going to be able to get to this whole weld here on the back, this one. We'll probably do this one too, just to strong that one up before we do that. So we're going to clamp this down to the table really good with a bunch of clamps, probably tack weld it down too in a couple spots. And then we're going to do this long weld here, probably in like four sections. I mean, that's a pretty long weld. That's 24 inches there. So, all right, let's get this welded up. Cue the music. The back side of this, the left side frame cradle. While that's cooling down, we don't want to do the last weld there, we want it to cool. We're going to go ahead and assemble the right side frame cradle. We've got all the pieces cut out here ready, so Derek's going to go ahead and start tacking it together. Let's do it. All right, guys, now that we got all the welding done to that we're going to before we, you know, pull the 4Runner cab and powertrain out and roll the frame over to fully weld everything. So Derek and I are gonna put this underneath the truck, kind of in its home where it goes, and kind of tack weld it on really good to where we can put the weight of the 4Runner on it without it moving and stuff. And then we're gonna go ahead and finish assembling the right side cradle and get it put on the frame as well. So let's do it. Cue the music. Now that Derek and I got that left side cradle all positioned on the frame perfectly, completely flush, now we're ready to go ahead and get it welded on to where it goes. Well, we're gonna lay some heavy welds around it. We're not gonna fully weld it on until we pull the cab and the engine and the powertrain out of it and roll the frame over to weld it so it's perfectly flat. But we're gonna weld it on enough so we can put the weight of the vehicle on it while we're doing mock-up and prototype of the 4-link kit on it. So, all right, let's get this welded up. guys, all finished up working on the phone. That was a couple days of work there. Got that work done. What'd we do? We pretty much cleaned up all the pieces that put together the left side cradle, and we got that assembled and modified the way it needed to be to match the curvature of the inside of the frame rails, where they kind of curve inward a little bit. So that's where that plate that bolts to the clamps to the inside of the frame rails needed to be curved to that shape. And then we were able to get that all tacked together and put together how it needed to be. And then we did some full welding on it where it will be against the frame rail, where we won't be able to get to once it's in there. You know, it sits in there like this. So that area, you can't weld there. So we welded right there, and the end piece is where you can't get to. But we clamped it down on the welding table really tight with multiple clamps, so that way it wouldn't, that's Derek leaving, so that way it wouldn't warp or move. And we got that all welded up in those places. And then you could see where Derek put those strong backs on, so it wouldn't allow any movement. And then he just cut those off and cleaned that up. And then we put it on the 4RUNNER frame, which he also metal prepped there. We did a little more than we did in the last episode. He got it perfectly flat in the areas where the left side cradle sits. And then Derek and I got that clamp down super tight, everything flushed where it needed to be, and then we were able to do some small welds in five or six places on that. We're not going to fully weld the cradles until we pull the cab and the powertrain, and we're going to put the frame on two engine stands. We'll be able to roll it upside down, and then you can lay those welds there and have it perfectly level in front of you and flat, so that way you're not worrying about any overhead welds or anything like that. So that way all the welds will look symmetrical. So, and then Derek and I, tomorrow we'll take and we'll assemble the right side cradle. I'm trying to break that habit. When people say things passenger side, driver side, that's incorrect. It's always from the driver's seat's perspective, left or right. Little top tip there for you. But yeah, so we're gonna get the right side cradle. We'll get that tacked together and put on the frame and welded up where we can't get to it, those areas on the cradle. And then we'll put it on the frame and weld it on in five or six places. And then we'll be able to move on to a radius arm mount. So Derek and I will do the right side off camera. So that way it's not another cradle video. You guys have watched a couple already. I'm sure you're kind of sick of it. So, and then in our next episode here, we'll get a plate of steel. I ordered a 4x8 plate of pickled in oil, 1/4 inch. So we can be able to cut out all four radius arms. So that'll be pretty exciting to move on to that, guys. And then after that, we'll move on to bridges and steering and trusses. So until then, guys, thank you guys so much for watching. Thanks for your constant support, as always. Thank you for being patient and waiting for us to be back working on the 4RUNNER again. You know, it's been a long time working on customer projects, but you know, they take priority over my own. So now that we're back on this, we can move back on to prototyping the 4-link kit for the 5th-gen 4RUNNERs and 3rd-gen Tacomas. So that's pretty awesome. But anyways, hey, thanks again, guys. Please hit the like and subscribe. Hit the bell up there so you guys get notifications. And if you guys like Cougar House Garage, you like what we do, check us out at cougarhousegarage.com. Check us out at Facebook.com/CougarHouseGarage. And we are Cougar House Garage on Instagram, guys. Follow along with the daily story there and all the crazy projects. And we'll catch you guys in the next episode. Thank you.